Good evening and welcome to Cliffyland's Global Cooking Challenge as we continue our four-year-long Round the World Alphabetical Learn to Cook Challenge as we work our way from Afghanistan to Zimbabwe in our one country a week experiment in learning to cook. Tonight is week and country number 182 of 193, and tonight is night two of cooking the food of Ukraine. Tonight we are making liapuni, I hope I'm pronouncing that right. These are Ukrainian crepes with a meat filling, and we're also going to be making beets in cream. And we are simulcasting on Periscope as well as on Meerkat. So the Periscope people will again be getting the bird's eye view of the prep and cook, and the Meerkat people will be getting a little more of the chit-chat with the community conversation action thing. So, let me get my lens on here for the Meerkat. That's me. And there we go. And give me a second here while I prop you up. And get everyone situated. Hello, Tammy. Thank you for the like and the restream. And sorry for the confusion last night. The Meerkat is obviously still busted with the scheduling thing. I don't know if it'll ever be fixed at this stage. Okay, now to get the Periscope people. Hello, thank you for joining us. Gonna flip you around here and then gonna position you so you can see what's going on. That's my big face. And so then get you where you can see the action and make sure that you're attached so you don't fall down again. I'm gonna give you a little closer view. There we go. Okay, so we're gonna start it. Hello, smiles back. I'm doing okay. Just all wiped out. Another one of those 5 a.m. runs, and my schedule is all turned around. So we are going to start off with our beets in cream sauce, for the simple reason that those have to cook for about an hour. So let me get my beets. And before anybody says anything, yes, I know. I know that I can keep the greens and use them later. I have been studiously collecting the greens for a little while now. As I've been using them, because the first time that came up, I found a nice recipe for the greens, and then promptly realized that just, you know, the greens from one bunch of three beets amounts to nothing once they're cooked. So it's gonna be a while. So let me clean these off a little bit. I mean, they're gonna be boiled and such, but let me clean them off. We're gonna peel them after they're cooked. And we, as we cook them, we're going to be careful to add lemon to the water to keep them from bleeding too much. Let me see. Tammy says, Cliffy, I ask, how do you stream cooking on Periscope while cooking? How do you read their comments since they fly by? I can't. That's kind of one of the problems with Periscope. If somebody comments, I probably won't see it unless I happen to be looking over my shoulder. Hello, Brunsbob. Thank you for joining. Yeah, that's one of the problems with Periscope. I've just kind of come to accept it. I hope I don't offend anyone. Although one of the weird things about Periscope is that the second that somebody joins, you see in live time, there's no delay like there is in Meerkat. So if you're a viewer, it's kind of freaky when you want to like jump in and back out and go, never mind, because the person's seen you. I always feel awkward when I'm the viewer and that happens. So, I'm gonna save these. Do they get upset? I don't know, no one said anything yet. See, like someone just said something and it disappeared. So that's kind of the problem. I think that was some kind of greeting. I saw two emojis at the end. Yeah. Weird how that works. So we're gonna get our beets and get them going. I could have gotten canned cooked beets, but you know, if I have the choice, I'll try to go for fresh, as opposed to canned or frozen. Just saying hi. Yes, hi. That's kind of what I thought. Hello, Bob. So we've got our three beets. So thankfully, that should be just enough for that. Let me freeze the rest of these. I have to remember I have like four batches of beet greens in the freezer. You know, when I made a dish with beet greens, it came out really well. But like I said, it was just so little that I said I can't do that again until I get a whole bunch. Thanks for the hearts. I mean, like, a lot of bunches, rather. A bunch of bunches. Meanwhile, thank you for the hearts. This right here, we got our beets, and we're going to put them in a pot of water. Now, since there isn't a whole lot happening in this particular instance on the stove, I should have tilted. This isn't a whole lot of action happening on the stove in this instance. I'm just going to put these... I'm not going to move the camera back and forth just for this. So we're going to put our beets in our water. And I'm going to put some lemon juice in that. Which means I need to get a lemon. You know what? Speaking of lemons, I need to separate out some lemon juice because I'm going to need lemon juice about three different ways here. So there's going to be lemon juice for the beets, and then there's going to be lemon juice for the other dish. So let me clean this off real quick. And so I'm gonna need my ramekin for the. I promise you, if you're on Periscope, that when you get to the stove, you'll get the bird's eye view, which will be really more than worth watching it on Periscope. So I'm gonna need to get some juice out of these lemons. It's gonna have to be a total of 3 tablespoons. Two one way and one the other, but I never know how much it's going to be from any particular lemon. So, let's see what happens here. Better view on Meerkat. Ah, well, yes, because you're not missing, especially when I go to the stove. Rough fly. So let's see how many tablespoons this works out to. Hi, Bob. Hope you're doing great. Oh, hi, Bob. Do you get that Bob Hope thing a lot? Punctuation matters. Okay, that looks like... How much do I need? 2 tablespoons for this one. So let's keep going. You need to get more juice out of your lemon if you, Maid, greetings. If you rub it on the counter, also if you, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna microwave it for 10 seconds. You get a little more juice out of your lemon that way. Just 10 seconds. Yeah. Good times. Okay, so more juice for the lemon. Okay, back to you. And see what I mean? More juice. It sounded like something else in the beginning. Anybody know who Tom Lehrer is? I was just listening to one of his more famous songs.
sounds like the beginning of one of them. Okay, so for here, again, we're looking for 2 tablespoons one way and 1 tablespoon the other way. So we're going with 2 tablespoons here, and the other will go the other way, which we will save for later over here. Okay, so we're gonna add in camera. Like I said, I don't feel like moving you back and forth camera-wise across the room for this particular one step. So I'm just gonna foolishly put everything in here. And then stick it on the stove. We're going to boil it for about 45 minutes to an hour. So, we got that going. I need to clean my cutting board and my knife. And then we can kind of get the other 2 little bits to make the cream for the beets. And then we'll move on to the details on the crepes. In going through getting my menu for my Ukrainian dish tonight, it was not easy because, as I mentioned, we are 182 countries in, which means we've done every neighbor. And the food of any one country is similar to that of its neighbors. Which means that borscht, everything is at cliffyland.com. You can find links to the original recipes, pictures, videos, information about the countries and reviews how everything went. You can follow it on Facebook, look for Cliffyland, facebook.com/cliffyland, or on Twitter at Cliffyland, on Instagram, Pinterest, or on YouTube. You can subscribe to the YouTube channel. And that's a good way if you feel like, you know, catching up on something you missed, especially now that catch is going to be gone. Anyway, so we did cold borscht for Belarus, which is way back before Meerkat and the letter B. We did a hot borscht for, I believe it was Romania, which is also a neighboring country. We did pierogies for Poland, and that was on Meerkat, and that's on YouTube also now. And they call pierogies pierogies something on the east side of Ukraine and something else, which is not in my head right now, in the western part of Ukraine. And they also have a thing that's spelled like pierogies, but instead of pierogi, it's called pierogi. And that's sort of like a big meat, like a big pastry with meat and or cabbage inside. And that served a lot more people than we have, so I decided not to do that, which left me with something with beets. I had to have something with pork, since pork seems to be like the food. And so I went up with these crepes. But about the beets, let's quickly put together the sauce for the beets. And just a couple things to add to this bowl right here, and that's going to be a 1/2 teaspoon of salt. I'm gonna try to experiment with something, but we'll see how it goes. Okay, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of pepper. This is like dead easy. This is just really a side dish. The only reason I'm doing this part now is because I can get it out of the way while I get to my crepes. So here we go. 1, 2, 3. 1/2 teaspoon of pepper. I'm gonna experiment with kind of making videos, like short videos out of this. Hello, Yolanda. How you doing? Thanks for the like and the restream. Yes, I've been looking at Nom and wondering if I could possibly do my thing over there. Hello, Burak Batali. Thank you for joining us. We're doing our food from Ukraine. I'm making our beets in cream sauce. And this is the cream sauce I'm making right now. We're getting 1 teaspoon of mustard. I've decided to go with Dijon here. taste well.
Okay, one more time.
1 teaspoon of mustard. And and then we're going to add 4 tablespoons of sour cream. Screenshot! Oh golly gee. What can I hear? A knife. I'm gonna get you. Oh, hope that worked. Okay. Let me clean off my... Okay, so we're gonna add, 4 tablespoons of sour cream. And here we go. Four tablespoons of sour cream. I'm practicing doing it an ingredient at a time that way. So maybe before too long I'll be able to take little videos instead and cobble it together into a short, like 4 minute video. 2, 3, and 4. That's messy enough. Did you say crepes? Yes, crepes. Technically, they say pancakes. So, I use the word crepes. But, technically, their descriptions all say pancakes. So we're gonna whisk that together. And we whisk that together. And this is what's gonna be covering our beets once they're cooked. We're still waiting for them to come to a boil there. But they're gonna have these pancakes / crepes can have a meat filling or a vegetable filling. I've decided to go with a meat filling because I'm kind of a meat person. From what I read, the meat filling can have, it'd be dressed with horseradish, which I have to remember to do. Or the vegetable filling can be done with a mushroom sauce. Although there was not a recipe for a mushroom sauce, I'm sure I could have found one if I was so inclined. So we have our cream sauce, which we're gonna cover our beets in. But while we wait, what goes in the fridge, by the way, these are lily pads. I don't make any money off them. I wish I did. Charles Vianson silicone lids. They're phenomenal. They lift and separate. So that's going to go in the fridge. Now, I kind of cheated. This morning, I already did make my batter for the pancakes because they work best when they sit for a few hours or overnight in the fridge. So rather than, you know, freak out now, I did that before. So that was basically eggs and flour and milk and water and salt, and that's it. And it just went in the fridge and has been there since about noon today. So now we can finally move on to making our I'm hoping I'm getting the pronunciation right. Mlyntsi, meat-filled Ukrainian pancakes. And just 2 things to prep here and trash for the meat filling. It's going to be 1 onion just coming right up. Got about a Everybody, polka. Okay. Chop, chop. So today, I don't know if anyone knows the calendar and such and their history, but it's kind of ironic in a sad way that today is the day that we are doing the food of Ukraine. Because today is the 30th anniversary of the meltdown at the Chernobyl nuclear reactor in Ukraine, outside of Kiev, the nation's capital. And that was an unspeakable horror that, because of the Soviet Union at the time and such, was all, you know, very hidden. But today, believe it or not, while it's still, you know, kind of under concrete and radioactive in parts, you can actually tour it. I made the acquaintance of a young man from Ukraine who, and I was just startled to hear, that, yeah, just took a tour out there and like, oh yeah, it's kind of radioactive, but they can still, you know, you can still take a tour. And that kind of freaked me out. Yes, really. So, just weird trivia. Just kind of, I noticed it when it came up yesterday. There are very haunting pictures of it even today, where you see, you know, empty Ferris wheel, and you know, what looked like a children's hospital with the toys just still sitting around, and you know, big mountains of gas masks, and just as they were, untouched by, you know, not touched since. It's very freaky and very disturbing. The people of Ukraine have dealt with a whole lot over the centuries, and they not, and the recent history and ancient history as well, from being at the middle of a lot of conquering on the parts of the Mongols and this, and then the Russians, and then the Soviet Union and World War II. Like, lots and lots of people died. It was very it's kind of a weird place to be, and then the whole thing with the Russians and the Crimea and whatever, it's, you know, it's difficult. Meanwhile, hello Emily, how you doing? Good to see you, thank you for the like and the restream. We are making our meat filling for our pancakes for Ukraine. It's Mlyntsi. Mlyntsi. And then there's a name with the meat filling, but I didn't write that down. It's long, and I get the impression that the and, I could be wrong, is just the letter Z. What are you talking about? I was talking about the history of Ukraine in Eastern Europe. They are the second largest country in all of Europe, only behind Germany. And yes, check up on your World War II history or you know, and before. It's a very difficult, sad, you know, story of resilience of the Ukrainian people. And then, you know, recently with their toll, again, the business with the Crimea and Russia, and then the Malaysian jet, which is shot down. Things haven't been particularly easy. Aras, hello, thank you for the like. Pancakes, yes, pancakes. Worked on the filling, like I said, earlier today, did not stream that. I just took pictures for the blog. Gave myself a little break. And have that in the fridge. They say it works best if it's been overnight. These pancakes, these meat-filled pancakes, the pancakes themselves, or even the meat-filled pancakes, apparently, can sit, can be frozen and used at some later period. I'm trying to finely dice these. Okay, now we're gonna simmer down those until about 7:15, 7:20. Aras, greetings. Apologize, the meerkat doesn't translate stuff. And they're mincing our onion. Trying to mince it as fine as I can. It's weird. One of the recipes calls for like a white onion, but I just can't. I don't think they really meant a white onion. I think they meant a yellow onion. Because white onions, specifically white onions, to my understanding, are kind of particularly used in Latin America for salsas and such. It would strike me as odd to see it in a Ukrainian recipe. So let's get our onion put aside here. And then we're going to do the same thing with a carrot. I feel like I'm at Oktoberfest or something. I know that's German. There's such crossover. Okay, so onions. I do not cut yourself, pretty please. I'll be fine. That was really weird that when I cut myself that other time. That was the first time in over a year that I even nicked myself. So there's a key to being careful when you're cutting, and it's to use. You missed my message. Oh dear. How did you choose to do Periscope from above? How did you choose? Hey Yolanda. Well, I figured that you could see this that you can't see here with Periscope, and that's kind of the why. And the quality is better now that I have a new iPad. You missed my message. Aras, I'm sorry I didn't understand. I know a lot about that. My teacher likes it, gives us extra lessons sometimes. Ah, I see. Okay, so we're gonna get to our carrots. Now, I mean, you're in the Netherlands, so I'm sure you probably get, more in depth on at least the European theater in World War II. There was, yeah. I went to Oktoberfest once since I live really close to Germany. Yes, they have lots of Oktoberfest here in the US because there's a very large German population in most of the central to eastern part of the United States. It's kind of interesting how that worked. The American history and hiring the Hessians, and they fought what with the British. But they were considered, by the people that lived in the state, the non-Native American people lived in the states at the time as being very foreign. And then now it's kind of like you can't be more American than that. It's just weird how the politics of things change over here. Where I lived in Ohio for a while, huge German population, people of German origin. There was a whole German village, they called it, and it was very cute little houses in the town, and every year, of course, they'd have the Oktoberfest and a German festival, which is separate, and Oktoberfest happening in September. Cliffy, I have to go to the store. I'll come by back later. Thanks. Good seeing you. I'll catch you later, Tammy. Thank you for coming by. So, we're going to peel and dice our carrot. Am I right? Yes, finally chopped my carrot. Maybe I feel like I'm at Disney. Went to the German Pavilion. We've gone many, 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 many times to Disney. The German Pavilion is very nice. It always gets very crowded. They have a beer hall there where they put on a very nice show, the Oompa-Pa Band. But when we went the first time we went, we sat and we were with these people and we're trying to make a good impression because you're at this communal table of people you don't know. And we're chatting and everyone orders a flight of beers. So like a big tray with one of, like 8 beers or something. So this waiter has got a tray with, like 16 different beers on it. And then he dumps the entire tray accidentally right over my husband's head. right over his clothes and everything, totally soaking him. And the poor deer, he was so embarrassed. I mean, they wound up buying him a free shirt and everything. Emily says, "We who still have hiding bunks, not four tornadoes, no bombs I have seen in 2 days ago." Yes, it is so creepy as crap, and Freddy Krueger doesn't scare me. Yeah, well, you're very young. In the throughout the cold, at least here in the States, I mean, I'm sure there's a, you know, with the World War II happening right there, that, you know, added additional layers of, oh my God, to everything. But here, in the 50s and 60s and 70s, that we had, people had bomb shelters in their backyard, and our neighbors had one. You know, it's like when the Russians drop the bomb, you know, everyone run there and we'll have our provisions and hopefully we'll survive the end of the world. And we had to do practice in school. We had to hide under the learn to hide under the desk when the air raid siren came, and follow the teacher to, you know, the gymnasium and put our heads under the, you know, under the table, thinking that our little desks would protect us from a nuclear bomb. So it was a very different time. Poor husband. What is Jung? There, you lost me. That's still Emily, yeah. So this is our carrots. We're dicing up our carrots here, which always wind up going everywhere. These are gonna be chopped up and then used, we're gonna saute these with the onions and some pork. This recipe calls for, you know, X amount, like 2 cups of cooked meat. It could be beef, it could be pork, it could be veal. I decided to go with ground pork, and rather than, you know, have it cooked ahead of time, I'm cooking it in with the onions and carrots. This is like dead simple. There's gonna be one interesting young, yes. There's gonna be one interesting wrinkle, one really curious ingredient that this recipe calls for, that we don't have the specific ingredient, but we're gonna try to fake it. But you'll see that in just a minute after I put this away here. And dice up that carrot. Ah! I hate having to mop after I cook. All right, that's enough. So we're gonna get our carrots going in here. Ah, sorry. Greetings. Hello. I wish I knew Russian. I just know dosvidanya. That's all I know. And da. I watch the Americans and they're speaking in Russian and the subtitles are in English, and I picked up on is that. The husband took Russian. He knows a little bit of Russian. Me, nothing. Okay, carrots. Sorry, I'm blind. Glasses still broke. Oh dear. So we have our carrots. Everybody in here, follow me. Okay, do that. All 2 people. Margo, hello. Thank you for joining us. We are cooking the food of Ukraine. Tonight we're making Mlyntsi. I hope I'm getting that right. Meat-filled Ukrainian pancakes. We have the batter in the fridge. This is the meat filling we're working on right now. As soon as I clean this off, you're gonna see the mystery ingredient, but how we're gonna try to recreate the mystery ingredient, okay? So, one moment while I wash this off. As I was looking on Periscope, seeing, thank you for the hearts. I was looking at the, trying to find other people in Ukraine to see, you know, but they were talking and it was lovely, but, you know, naturally they were talking in Russian and I felt weird not knowing how to say. Been like that for 2 weeks. Oh dear. You're gonna have headaches if you can't see. Okay. So, I think that might actually do it for our cutting. Yay. So, our mystery ingredient. Step forward and sign in, please. Be right back. This is for the grown-ups in the room, people. Okay, I need to find it, because it's not, it's something I have, not even something I can say that I bought. Something that I have, that somebody gave me once, that it's so weird that I even have it, that I'm not even exactly sure where I have it, or even if I have it. What the heck is that? No, that's not it. Aha, here we go. Yep, whiskey. Whiskey. It's Irish whiskey. It's, you know, I don't really drink much. So, I had a client who I went to help him one time, and then the very old man, like in his 90s, and he wouldn't let me out the door without giving me the bottle of whiskey. A whole new bottle. And apparently it's fancy whiskey. I don't know from whiskey. But in Ukraine, they have a kind of flavored whiskey, which is... which you can kind of make yourself if you feel like doing it. You take the whiskey and soak it with 10 cayenne peppers. If a cat has a cat, then a cat is a... What? If a cat has a cat, then a cat, then a kitten. Okay. Whiskey. So we're talking booze. Hard stuff. 1 tablespoon of whiskey. Like I said, this stuff would normally be, I don't remember the name. I wish I did. But it'll have a hot cayenne flavor. Sorry, I'm teasing you. It's okay. A hot cayenne. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna add cayenne pepper to the dish to sort of approximate the cayenne flavored whiskey. Should I take a shot? No, I'm not going to take a shot. I'm tempted, but I'm not. So, this only comes out when we have parties and someone insists on having whiskey. So, whiskey. And that's an optional ingredient. So, next we're going to get out some nutmeg. And we learned last time I dealt with nutmeg that the nutmeg I bought is good and fresh, and it's the whole nut of the nutmeg. And so when comes time to use the nutmeg, we are going to grate it into the dish. So we have our nutmeg corn kernel. Somewhere I saw it was written as a corn, a K-O-R-N, but I did not see any reference to that anywhere else. We're going to use the rest of that lemon back over there. And golly gee, it is 6:39. Sorry, I'm not allowed to have booze. Well, you're too young. That is understandable. We're going to have 1 tablespoon of butter. Which we happen to have right here. And wow, are we ready? Okay, I guess we're ready to start making our filling. So first, the Periscope people. Hi, you're going for a little trip. Everybody, flying, whee! Okay, unmoor you. And upsy-daisy. Yay! You never take me anywhere! Okay. Ah, there you go. So now you get the real cool bird's eye view. That's when the Periscope... Stupid law. You're too young. When I was a little kid, only on New Year's in just a little bit. Well, that makes sense. When I was a little kid, I was in Europe. I don't even want to remember how long ago. I remember how long ago that was. I just don't want to say. This needs more water. I was a little kid, and there was a younger little kid
coconut rum and cocoa soap Coca-Cola.
Rum and Coca-Cola. Yeah, there's even a song about that. So,
I was in England, and I was a little kid, and I was with a friend of the family who was even a littler kid, and the kid was a brat, a huge, huge brat, and we were without our parents, and there, I guess the laws are different in England, and so he just walked up and asked for a martini at the bar, and they gave him a glass of, martini brand vodka or something, I think. You put the lime in the coconut and mix it all up. Yeah, you know that song is way, way before your time. I was a little kid when that song came out. Not that you're a little kid. Brats get their way. Yeah, well, this kid was a big old brat. Now he's a big old eye doctor. But then my parents came, and or rather his dad and my dad came and saw, you know, him sitting there with this big glass of booze in front of him. And I was just saying, you can't be drinking that. And he's like, I can drink what I want. And his dad took it from him and then drank it himself. It looked like that big. Of course, when you're a kid, everything is in a different perspective. We're getting our stuff over in this direction over here so we can have it ready. True, and my mom too, snap. And let's get our ground pork over here ready to go also. I've got about a pound of it. This is gonna be our meat filling. So, and I need to get my camera to take the picture. So I start off by melting about a tablespoon of butter in the pan. I am practicing. Holy crap, too much booze for that child. Jeez, too much booze for, that's a big bottle of booze for anybody. That's a lot of booze for a grown man. I don't know what the deal was. I just remember being shocked. Okay. I'm gonna get the plastic wrapping off of this sucker. Everybody, I feel like I should be dancing around the handkerchief right now. Okay, pork. I love that spoon. Yeah, it's really nice, and I got it at the grocery store of all places. Silicone, I like the little African theme. Oh, I've got, I mentioned phase two for after I finish with Zimbabwe, and we do like Puerto Rico and some other territories, and I take my much needed vacation where I'll be away for a while. However, the working on branding and logos and stuff for phase two, I'm thinking about Nom. Nom is an app and website you can find at nom.com, and it's all food. I just, it seems, it's a little intimidating, because it seems a lot more professional than our little dog and pony show we have here. So, hopefully in the next few months I'll be able to practice and get stuff going. So I can be ready. So, we're going to heat this up a little more. I need to melt that so it can simmer. That music is so obnoxious. So it's fun. It's festive. Also, one of the reasons I tend to play folk music of country X or Y whenever I'm doing this is, it can be weird sometimes. However, among other things, it helps less problems with the copyright police on YouTube. Have you heard when Meerkat will end? I wish others had stayed longer. You know what? I'm not on as often, and as you and I both know, there's for most of the people that are on Meerkat day to day now, there's a language barrier. And so I don't really get what's being said, which is, you know, not my, it's not their fault, it's, you know, mine. From that one little bit of information that I heard, I didn't hear that it was going away, but rather that it's going to change. So, so I wouldn't worry too much, at least at this point. Although, Catch is going away on the 4th, which is disappointing, because that's going to affect how I put stuff online. Go, Cliffy, go. Thank you. Okay, so we've got this sizzling. Now we're going to add in our onions. Adding in our one chopped onion. And now add in our one chopped carrot. And we're going to cook that until it softens. Thought that they had a date in mind. They might have, and I might have not gotten that information. If that happens, then that moves up my plans vis-a-vis, Nom. Because Periscope is, it's got its charms. That sizzle, though. Yay! And so you want to cook till it's softened. You want to soften the onions and the carrots first. Let the chemical reaction happen first here. And then we're going to add in the pork and the nutmeg and the whiskey. And we're going to add a pinch of cayenne or more to the dish to try to approximate that whiskey, that spiked whiskey action. And somewhere there's going to be lemon. Yes, and lemon juice. That's coming up later, too. Hello, Manchester. Greetings. How are you doing this? It would be night for you. We've got our microplane. We're going to grate our nutmeg into this. Again, we are cooking the food of Ukraine for our second of two nights here. We're making a Mlyntsi, Mlyntsi, Mlyntsi. It's a meat-filled, these are going to be meat-filled, Ukrainian pancakes. You know what I want. Hello. Flexum. Do you know why they call it? I don't even know what you're talking about. There you got me. I'm thinking I'm being set up for a joke here. Meanwhile, we're still simmering the beets. We're trying to, anyway. Until about 7:15. I gather that they peel easier when they after they've been cooked. But of course, we'll have to drain them, which means getting out the colander right here. Het Bitsen. I don't even know what that is. So it seemed to have softened a bit. So I think we can go ahead and add in our ground pork here. That's of course going to release its own fat. So now we add in the ground pork. And we'll work that through. Till it's cooked, basically. Channel. Oh, that is one of the things you made for Holland on your channel. Ah! See, I don't... I remember I totally messed something up. The potatoes thing. Which was disappointing. So, round two, I'm hoping that I improve on things that I didn't do well. And, and I don't mess up things I did well before. Warm thunder is the translation. There's a bad joke in there somewhere. Warm thunder. Okay, so we got this kind of on a medium heat. And we want to brown the meat here. Yep. And we have to cook the meat first. Do you know why they call it warm thunder? No, I do not know why they call it warm thunder. Why did the chicken cross the road? To keep his pants up. Why do firemen wear red suspenders? To get to the other side. Where is the obnoxious music? The music's still there. Hey, Lavender Femchi, how you doing? Thank you for the like and the restream. We're working on our filling for our meat-filled Ukrainian pancakes. This is the meat filling of the meat-filled pancakes. The recipe called for the meat to be cooked already at this stage, but this is so basic. I don't see how I'm screwing. How I could possibly be screwing this up? Cooking the meat now with the onions and carrots. Which will be the filling while we cook our beets. For a cute joke. You're welcome. I am so thirsty. My circadian rhythms are all upside down. I wake up at 5 and go run 10 miles and come back and have breakfast and like collapse for 2 hours and then get moving again and then collapse again. So I don't even know what day of the week it is from time to time. Because you make it really warm and then you eat it in the winter when the weather is and then it thunders, so it's warm thunder. Ah, well, there you go. Cool. Good to know. I will, in 3 years when I get back to doing that dish again, I will tell that story. It is so warm. Speaking of warm, it's warm standing over the stove. Ah, what's the temperature? Okay. I hope they got right side up. But it doesn't really matter. Yeah. I mean, if somebody wrote something up, no, I would see it. Okay. Trying to figure out the person. No! I'm not bothered by it. It's just not, in case my mom were to pop in. But they're not somewhere where they have access to Wi-Fi right now. So she's missing the show. Okay, so now that this is sort of like what I'd look for when you make the lettuce cups for Thailand with the cooked pork, the ground pork. Okay, so now here is where we're going to add in the half a teaspoon of I'm just going to use this whole kernel of nutmeg, and I don't know how I'm going to take this picture, so here goes. And add in the grated nutmeg. Ooh, I just realized something. It says, come back. It says half a teaspoon. I'm gonna use this whole business right here. This is hurry up music. Hope it's not too much nutmeg I'm adding here. Okay, there we go with the nutmeg. Nutmeg accomplished. So this is gonna add some flavor to this. And to that we're gonna add the whiskey. And we're not lighting it on fire. And the whiskey. And to give it that cayenne flavor, to try to fake the cayenne flavor in the cayenne flavored whiskey, we're gonna add in a pinch of cayenne. Or two, or three, or four. Technically it said they put in 10 cayenne peppers into the whiskey for, you know, overnight or day or something like that. That smells different already. Now that we've added our nutmeg and our whiskey and our cayenne pepper, we're gonna add our lemon juice. Ow. And mix it all up. And then we're gonna add salt and pepper to taste, which means Cliffy needs to taste his food. Did you taste your food? Do my best Padma Lakshmi impression. Okay. Interesting smell. Now we've got some sour going here from the lemon. A little bit of citrus. Add the salty and the peppery here. Salt. And pepper. Okay. Salt and pepper. And we're gonna have to taste that sucker and see how that went. Who is your favorite Disney character? That is a lovely question. And I have a feeling that you won't know who this is. Either Toulouse or Berlioz from Aristocats. I get which one is which. Confused. But you'd have to have seen Aristocats, and that's like the least well-known Disney, one of the least well-known Disney movies. It's with cats. I saw it a million times when I was a kid. Here goes. Yummy. A little bit of heat. Could use some more salt. I'm getting that acid from the lemon, which is good. That's my favorite movie. It is! Oh, that's so cool! I knew we clicked. That's wonderful. So again, for those just joining us, Cliffyland, around the world, 4-year-long Learn to Cook Challenge, where I learned to cook by doing the food of a different country in alphabetical order, one country a week, going around the world from Afghanistan to Zimbabwe. This is week number 182, night 2 of the food of Ukraine. Tonight we are making the Mlyntsi, meat-filled Ukrainian pancakes. These happen to be meat-filled. They don't have to be. They can be vegetable-filled. Which would be a slightly different recipe. Okay, let's taste it again. Mine is the mother cat from this. Oh, yes! Marie! No, Marie's the girl. Duchess! Duchess is the mother. Played by the late, great Eva Gabor. She was so great. That is so cool. That tastes good. Nice little bit of heat. So now we're taking this off the heat. I watched the Dutch. It was not fun at all. Oh dear. I can't imagine the voices would be... Oh, well, listen, I grew up watching cartoons that I was used to seeing in English. I'd watch them in Spanish when I was in Puerto Rico with the, you know, dubbed in Spanish. So the Flintstones and everything in Spanish. And it was very irritating. But then I kind of got used to the Spanish voices too and Spanish names. BRB, going to look in the movie on Netflix. I'd be surprised if it was there, but hey, you never know. Disney movies have a habit of purposely disappearing. Oh boy! We are perhaps a little bit ahead of schedule. I have to say one of my favorites is Lady and the Tramp. That's a lovely movie. Oh, hey, Jim! Lady and the Tramp is beautiful. That is just a lot. You know, I may have seen it when I was little, and too little to remember. And so it was many years until I saw it again, sometime in the last 10 years. See the Flintstones, yes. Meet the Flintstones. You probably don't know. The Flintstones comedy thing was a takeoff on a 1950s sitcom. Comedy from television called The Honeymooners, where, you know, it was set in the present day, then the 1950s, and the dad and the husband was a bus driver, and his friend worked in the sewers, and but they were, you know, sort of copies of that. So here's what we're doing. We have got a baking dish right here while we wait on our beets to finish. We're going to need to butter our dish. That's a bummer. Yeah, no, Disney doesn't like their stuff to be available all the time. Even the days of Netflix now. There's a thing called an app called Disney Movies Now, I think it's called. That even there you can't see everything, but you can see, I bet, more. It's their own private little Netflix, basically. Where you can see it on your iPad or what have you, Disney movies. But even then, they hide stuff, so it's not available, you know, and then they make a big deal about it coming back out again. It's very obnoxious. Because they want people to buy it and then make it go away. Okay, so we buttered our dish. I also like the movie Lady and the Tramp. In fact, I see that movie the first time Dutch. Also, Wall-E. Wall-E is a... That was a very nice movie. Maybe I want to say Hello, Dolly again. Okay, so now that we've buttered this dish, I'm going to preheat the oven to, was it, 325... Because we're going to do that later. That's why they can resell them years later from the vault. Exactly. It's the Disney vault. The Saturday Night Live did a whole sort of parody of the Disney vault thing in a kind of sarcastic way, which, considering, you know, I can't blame them. Lots of channels creating their own Netflix-style channels. Yeah, one of them just went under today, too. I just saw the news. Quick Flicks or something? I never even heard of it. So, yeah. So, what are we doing right here? We have our... I want to watch a movie, Mars Needs Moms. Do you know that movie? I've heard of it. Yolanda says, but subscribing to many would cost as much as cable. No kidding, even more. The whole CBS All Access thing, it kind of drives me a little crazy. Drives me a little crazy because I'm thinking, I've got Netflix, I have Hulu. I'm not paying for like another monthly thing and another monthly thing, and I'm, you know, and I got the Apple Music thing, and I have cable, I have HBO. It's like I can't pay just to the access to CBS shows. That's getting really out of hand. Do you know the Netflix series? Yes, Orange is the New Black is phenomenal. Although I think it's a little too mature for you, but hey, you know, what do I know?
Okay, what are we doing? We're getting out our batter,
which has been sitting in the fridge since noon.
Ta-da! This is our batter. Thus, my mom pays the Netflix. I would expect so. So, there isn't a whole lot, as you can see. So, I'm a little nervous, to be honest, because of the time. Because I don't know when the husband's showing up. So, I know they're going to have to get heated up in the oven again, which is why I heated up the oven. I'm very mature, Cliffy G's. Listen, I was two, and I know things change, and people are different now than they were before, and da-da-da, you know, so I'm old. Cut me a break. I'm looking for about 3 tablespoons. I'm gonna go with this. I hope it works. This is what I tend to use when I make pancakes. Does meat mixture taste like sausage? A little bit. Has a little bit of lemon, sour from the lemon, a little bit of kick from the cayenne. Netflix keeps raising prices just because they have shows like Fuller House, and it's really annoying even though I don't pay for it. Well, if you don't pay for it, you can't complain. The series is fun. Yes, it's very good. It's very good, I must say. Okay. I'm just kind of scared. I'm a little scared. I'm going to get me my rubber spatula. But thanks for being worried. Well, you know. Paternal inclinations, what do you want? Okay, get some plates out here for this. Oh, boy. Okay. Here goes nothing. So we're going to heat up our canola oil a little bit across the pan. I'm going to put this on kind of a medium heat here. And this is an 8-inch saucepan here. I'm going with a smaller. Okay, all over to coat the entire pan. I am really scared. And I wasn't allowed to watch my mom says what? Would say, so I asked for permission. Where are you in the series? Oh, we're caught up. Waiting for the next season to come out. That being said, if you like Sam Elliott, check out Ranch. Very funny. Oh, yeah, that's... I've made a list of things I need to watch. And, it was kind of in my head, but I officially made a list. And, who doggies? That list got long. So I'm looking for about 3 tablespoons. Which I'm guessing is about this much. And here goes... No, okay, how do I do this? I've been taking pictures at the same time. This is where I need a helmet cam. Okay. Mm-hmm. And the batter goes in. Okay, here goes. 1 tablespoon's worth, 2 tablespoons worth, 3 tablespoons worth, I hope. Don't spoil. No, I wouldn't spoil it. Ah! No. No. That, see, I have lots of bad luck with this. Too much oil, I think. Oh boy, that's not good. That's not good at all. No, that's not good. That's very bad. That's not good at all. Too much oil, I think. Shoot. That did not work at all. I think I put too much oil in. That sucks. Because I don't have that much batter. Shh.
waste it. Well, that one's a dud. Kind of to watch the next one. Probably after this I will, yeah. Well, we have our first one as a gimme. First one's a dud. It's supposed to be about 3 tablespoons, but it's hard to tell. There's really too much oil. We'll get them next time. I don't know how to make that, spread that out. Oopsie doopsie. Live and learn. If you saw my masala dosas from India, which were not on Meerkat, that was this mess times like 100 times worse. Okay. It's supposed to cover the entire pan, and it just totally didn't. So we'll learn from our mistakes. If we don't make mistakes, how can we learn from them? Yuck, mess. Just realize this white, you just can't see it on the screen. So it's about a minute on the other side. I don't know how to do it. Well, it's because I added too much oil. I added too much oil, that was the problem. Welcome back. This was not a good one. This is a bad one. This one was a goof. 3 tablespoons, it says. 3 tablespoons. Oh boy. That one did not go well. Okay. Nice side clip. Well, indeed. No, not so much. Okay. Well, we're gonna try again. Let's see if this works. Ahem. 3 tablespoons. Why does this happen? Spread thin. I want you to spread thin. You're not spreading thin. You're getting all gooey. Damn it. It's too thick to spread around like I would with, making a roti or something. If I say too much, just tell me. That's okay. I like that you keep me company. Shame about that light on this, but, can't be helped at this stage. I have it on kind of a medium heat. Did not really say what level heat to have this on. It's supposed to be really thin across the entire thing, but the sauce is not really watery enough to do that, and I'm afraid to add water to it. Because maybe that would thin it out too much. That's a ton of meat, and that's not a ton of batter. What did you think about the girl having full time, fun time with the officer or the mustache? Thin the better, yes. Thin the batter. Yeah, I think I will. Just just a little bit. Hope I didn't do it too much. Thank you for the tip, Lavender Femchi. Okay, how are we doing? Because this looks like strike two. They said pancakes. They didn't say crepes. I thought crepes. Because I'm used to, you know, folding crepes in and stuff. Not me folding crepes in. Other people folding crepes in. Need a lot more practice on this. Said just about a minute on these. But that is so much meat filling. And so much not batter. We're gonna find out. Well, great job. At least I got the flipping part down. Okay. Let's try. Well, we'll see. Let's try for the thinner one now. 1, 2, 3. This is a little more like it. And then here's where I need to see that it comes off from the sides. There you go. This is more like what we're looking for. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Nah, no, 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 da 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 no, 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 not yet, not yet, not yet, no, not yet. Come on. You always throw out the first three crepes. It's just the way it goes. Pan guys got hot enough. That looks like Dutch pancakes. Yeah, there's, you know, I'm sure there's a lot of similarity. This one actually worked. Yay! I feel like I wasted so much batter on that. Okay. Whoopty. Maybe could have stood for another second on there, but... Okay, here we go. Number four. Again with the hurry-up music. Another one for the blooper reel. Yeah. Those beets have been cooking for the better part of an hour now. But we'll get to those in a minute. OMG, how you save the broadcast? How you save this broadcast? Oh, well, right now Catch is still going. Right now the Meerkat save library, and I can take it down off of the Meerkat save library. Too, even though they're a little less reliable. And the last option is the Periscope, if it saves to the device, which if it's too long, it might not. So then things get a little scary. Cliffy, that sounds makes me hyper, lol, yes. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna flip it the old-fashioned way. I made such a mess of things. So less than a minute. Okay. Well, yeah, I'm a little worried about it because it's very important that I can do it with the Periscope as the last resort. Because if I can't do it there, then we're in trouble. Because Catch isn't doing it. I don't know, is anyone else doing what Catch does? I'm not aware of any other service doing that. If you find out about one, let me know. Okay, that's another one. Eek, hold on. Darn. Okay, have a oopsie. Okay, back to you. Making the mess is half the fun. That's a good way of looking at it. OCD makes life a little difficult on that front, but hey, you know, that's what medication is for. You know, I have some friends, and they are right now, they are in Turkey. I've been seeing all their pictures from Istanbul the last couple days. Then they're gonna go to Paris. So, my friends get to travel the world. I get to look at their pictures. That seems a little thin. This one seems a little extreme on the other end. I'm gonna need a our Beets over here. It smells like Beets in here. Okay. So Beets and Borscht. Okay. These are smaller than I first anticipated because they were saying, but I read it said 8-9 inch saute pan, so that's what I got. That's what I'm got. Where again will Beets come into play? Separate second dish, which is going to be Beets in the cream sauce. It's just about as basic gets. I just needed something to go on the side. They won't go into this dish, they're the side dish. I figured I needed a vegetable and I wanted something with Beets, since that's, you know, quite the thing. Ukraine, known as the breadbasket of Europe, wheat being a huge thing there. So bread is, bread is life. Bread is life in many parts of the world, and Ukraine, they grow the wheat on the amber waves of grain, as it were. Maybe we'll get the rest. Okay. I wasn't looking. Oh. Periscope has abandoned us. No, this Nom thing that I saw, it seems like a nice match, the Nom thing, though I'm reading their kind of, you know, tips for a successful Nomcast, and I was very, very intimidated, because it's talking about using an external webcam, and, you know, and the laptop, and putting up, you know, asking people to put in GIFs and images and pictures into the cast, you know, as things go, and I'm thinking, I can't direct, you know, I can't cook and, you know, be adding in, oh, here, everyone, look, here's a picture of what it looked like when it's done, and here's a picture of the amber waves of grain in Ukraine, and here's a gif of, you know, Donald Duck, and I got enough on my mind. I need to get some water. And also says the suggested length is, you know, 15 to 30 minutes. And we all know that that is not what I do here. So part of me wondered, hey, what about if I was doing my whole deal and then when I started firing the dish is when I would start the podcast or the nomcast. So we're gonna turn off the heat here. Yep, flippy. Alrighty. So now I need to hear. You stay there for a minute. We have our pancakes, crepes here, but we have our beets over here, and I need to drain the beets, so give me a minute to do that. That's gonna get messy over there, so you don't need to watch this. Ow, hot. Oh, brother. Hold on. Yay!
It's the husband.
Thank you. Okay, so we've got our beets here. And what did I do with the tongs? Here. Get them out of that hot pot. Let them cool off so then we can peel them. So I think we're gonna move everybody.
Hi.
Do I hear the cat?
Yes, it's coughing.
Okay, we're gonna let our beets cool off, and we're gonna start assembling the meat business. So, here, the nobody on Periscope, I'm gonna move. Over here, here.
Like music from Disney World.
It does, and I was saying that. I was just saying that. Okay. Is that really how it goes? Okay. And we'll move you back over. Okay. Meerkats here. Periscopers over here. Now, gonna move our beets over. We're gonna have to peel those. And we're gonna have to assemble our crepes with the meat, which let's scoop it into a bowl so I don't have to carry this whole thing. Okay, dude, grab an oven mitt and help grab this. Speed things up a little. Need to grab both ends. Oops, I guess you need a second oven mitt. It's underneath it. Dump it in, but it's very, very, very heavy. Okay.
Oops.
Yeah, we'll have to clean the floor anyway.
I don't want it to grease on us.
Yeah, well, that's the nut. Thank you.
Alrighty. So we have our meat filling. Is the husband home? Yes. So we have our meat filling over here. And now we need to get our greased baking dish over here. This is where everything's going to wind up landing. So the idea here is, and I need to take pictures. So the way this works is, goes down, then spoonful, let's get spoon. A generous spoonful of the meat stuffing in the middle. That seems like too much. Okay. And so can you see? All right. So we're gonna get that. So then we're going to lift the bottom up to the middle. Then bring in, this doesn't seem big enough and I'm not good enough at this. As we mentioned before, I am the world's worst rapper. They just call me Macklemore. Then over to the right, and then like an envelope up from the bottom. This is not right. And then seam side down into the baking dish, thusly. So we're gonna try that again. Okay, with old pancake, obviously we're gonna have leftover meat filling. Make a picadillo. Okay, up from the bottom, in from the sides. And up from the top. And then seam side down into the baking dish. Wait, do the left side, the bottom side, then the right side. This said specifically to do the bottom and then the left and the right and the top. So that's what I'm gonna do. It seems to be kind of working, so for what that's worth. So again, bottoms up, left side in. It's like an envelope. Right side in, and top side down. The top side is the one that's the trickier part. And then down there. Ah, kind of broke a little. Okay, we're gonna try another one until we get to the really crappy ones on the bottom, which we're almost there. Yeah, it's curious. We're not gonna have so much leftovers of the crepes as leftover crepe filling. Okay, up from the bottom, in from the right, in from the left, and up from the top. This is going to be really tricky when I get to the thick ones, which are coming up next. Okay. Yeah, this is really thick. Oh boy.
Thick dough?
The first two were kind of mistakes in figuring out how to do this. But I don't want to just throw them because there wasn't enough batter. There wasn't a whole lot of batter, so I had to make do. This is more pancake than crepe. But they said pancake, so not pretty. She is not pretty. Oh my, such leftovers on the meat. We'll just make some rice.
Okay. Ooh, this one was. This is the really ugly one. No one should be seeing this one. This one was the big old. The really bad first one. That one's gonna stay in the pan after it's all done. Okay. Arg! Arg, a music war. Arg. Okay, that's as good as that gets. Okay, Cliffy. Me amo Emily. Emily! Okay, so we've got you. Now I'm gonna wash my hands. Hopefully the beets are cool enough to handle now. Oh boy, Chef Panther, thank you for the like. I'm sorry you're seeing an embarrassing series of thingamajiggers here. So, we're gonna wind up putting this in the oven to warm. You know Spanish under me, no, that's not Spanish. Hola, hello, Cliffy, mi amo, that means nothing. That means my love you.
I love you?
Not even that. It would be me llamo, which is L-L-A-M-O. And that's M-A, M-E. So it would be me llamo. That means my name is. You good? Well, thank you. That's very kind of you. Now hopefully our beets are peelable. The peeler is... Okay. Find something for this. So, mi amo means I am. No. Not in Spanish it doesn't. That would be yo soy. No, me llamo is what you're trying to say. That's M-E and then L-L, which is the letter A in Spanish. Me llamo, L-L-A-M-O, me llamo, nah. Mi amo is nothing. Because mi, M-I, is my. You can say mi nombre es. If you say mi nombre es Emily, then there'll be M-I. But if it's, I call myself, like my name is, it's me llamo. Giving Spanish classes and food lessons at the same time. It's in Spanish, the verb to be, there is a differentiation between to be as in a state of physical being, and then as a state of existing. It's weird. So, soy and estoy. Like soy is I am. I'm like I am Puerto Rican. Yo soy Cliff. Yo estoy is my state. Like I am standing. Yo estoy parado. Okay. So, yeah, you could just pull the skin right off. You'd like a knife and just scrape and come right off. Yeah, I was sort of noticing that. Speaking of knives, I'll wash that. So, chopping the ends off. And what are we doing with this? Dicing it, I think. Oh. Yeah, so. Eek. This is trash. As you can tell, I haven't spent a lot of time peeling cooked beets before. It's like the Red Wedding here.
Hi, Kitty.
Yeah, this isn't... it's doing better with the... I imagine it would do better with a knife.
Kitty. It's one of your favorite times of the week. Why do you love this so much?
It will stain like hell. Yes. Emily says, hello, honey. Next time, buy the golden beets and you won't have to worry about staining. I think I've seen those. You know, the first time I used beets, I was scared as all get out when I cooked Belarus, when I did the cold borscht for Belarus. And I was so freaked out over the red and the staining and everything. I mean, yeah, it was really red and it got messy, but it, you know, cleaned right off. Which I was pleasantly surprised. Okay. You know what? I think I'm going to wind up putting those in the... keep them warm. And there's no difference in flavor. It's interesting. I know I've seen them at some point because I said that's really interesting. So beets. Yeah, this is maybe like the fifth or sixth time I've worked with beets now. So I'm not quite as scared as I used to be. If I could just peel it all off in one piece, I would.
Okay.
I mean, it's almost at that, but not quite. I was saying that on the Top Chef, they had a challenge for people to use as much of a thing, with wasting as little as possible. And the guy made a beet something, and he used the shavings, and he fried them. And apparently they were very tasty. So there was nothing left. There was no waste. We're not doing that here, but it's a nice thought. Okay, so we've got our messy beets.
Out damn spot!
What?
Out damn spot!
Yeah, I've stained my hands all right. I have golden beets from the farm, which is really awesome. That's where I learned about them. Interesting. Yeah, I've seen them in the store, like I said, and I was thinking that's pretty wild. I don't know what that is. Dice. We're dicing these. So then they're going to wind up in here. Good knife work. I acknowledge that. And up in here. I guess it's going to wind up being room temperature. What color is the cat? The cat is a big orange kitty. The big kitty. Very shy. As soon as he hears the pots and pans come out, he runs for the hills.
Well, he's down here now.
He's down here now, which is very unusual.
Yes.
Which is nice. Usually he's hiding like underneath the bed somewhere. Like clanking metal and thunderstorms. Sounds kitties do not like. Venom vacuum cleaners. Yay, orange and honey. And honey? Yay, orange. Yes, he's a big orange kitty. He's kind of a gigantor kitty. And not because he's overweight, he's just a big kind of cat. I assume I mentioned the whole tragedy with the tiger. Here last week,
more details have been emerging. Now it's like, it's, you know, made national news. They're thinking that she did something, the zookeeper did something wrong going in where she knew the tiger was, when she shouldn't have been there. Damn shame. But they saved the tiger, which is good. Because people were threatening to kill the tiger. Like, they didn't want to identify which tiger it was, but the news is like, it's news, we need to report it. But people are like, no, I'm going to bring a gun to the zoo and kill the tiger. I was like, no. So now the tiger needs protection. Welcome to Florida. Speaking of cats. That's the breed. I want to see him. No, he's very camera shy. Thank you for the restream, Chef. Yes, he's very camera shy. Follow me on Snapchat. Send me a DM on Twitter with your Snapchat username, and I will send you mine, or I'll add you. And then maybe you might see the kitty when he comes out. Okay, here we go. So we have diced our beets thusly, and now I need to wash my hands. And we're gonna put the pancakey things. Give me a sec, then. Not a problem. Those are gonna go in the oven, in there, to warm through. Yeah, it's at 325. Like I said, a couple of those look like garbage, but you know, them's the berries. And this looks like a crime scene. Hold on. Be right back. We're gonna mix up our cream sauce with the beets, and then we'll be ready for that. Alrighty, so we got our beets here, and our cream sauce is over here that we did at the beginning of all this. So we're gonna mix these two together. This will go this way. Okay. And so we add the cream sauce to the beets. There wasn't a whole lot of this cream sauce. So obviously it's not swimming in it. Oh wow, that really cleaned up nice. Well, I used a plastic cutting board. Wood did very well. Yeah, wood is apparently what everyone swears by. There are, I gather, keys to caring for your wood cutting board. Try not to let it, you know, stay wet at any, you know, for any, you know, period of time. And clean it off with lemon and salt. And also you can, every so often, wipe it with mineral oil, which you can buy in a drugstore even. And mineral oil. It gives a nice coating and keeps it happy and healthy and helps it resist water more. So that's your tips on cutting board the hoo-ha. So here we go, having some for you. Yummy. Quite yummy. I got the mustard. A little hint of mustard in there, that's good. Good, good, good. Yay! Okay, so it's been about 4 minutes. I assume that that's gonna be ready to be plated any moment now. So Periscope people are going for another little ride. I don't know how it got zoomed out so much, but into the sky you go. For plating time. Yep, upside down. Hold on. Ah! This way. Don't fall. We need you happy. Okay. And now, I didn't know about the cutting board. Thank you. Oh, well, I'm glad I was able to help. Yeah, check out the tasting table. It's a website, it's on Facebook. They're incredible. And they always have these interesting tips on all sorts of stuff that have been immeasurably helpful. And they have recipes. You know that, the beets have a nice little bit of a kick. The mustard, I am looking the wrong place. I'm looking at my plates. My plates. Okay. Oh boy. Hola! Who are we looking at here? Susie! Thank you for liking the restream. Greetings. Hola! And see that the table's ready for dinner. It is not. Hon? Oh boy. I hate it when this happens. Is he outside? Yeah, dinner's gonna be ready like now.
Okay,
So we have our beets and I need to get the oven mitts. Hopefully it's been heated through our little experiment in pancake stuffing. And there they are. Yeah, every time I do that, I think of that. I'm so nervous that this is going to fall apart. Need to be very, very careful. Okay. It's kind of warm, so that's a good sign. That's one. You can also fry them, apparently, in for about 5 minutes. Ow. And then that would also accomplish what you'd want. This is just to heat them through. I don't think they were in there for long enough. Nuts. They don't feel hot enough. Nope, not hot enough. Sorry, folks. False alarm. Need to go back in for a couple minutes.
Not yet?
Well, soon. And he grabs it with his bare hands. Genius move. Maybe just another, like, couple minutes. Dang it. Just two more minutes. Let me plate this while we wait. This could be the messiest part of the evening here. Beats me. Da-dum-dum. Okay. Hope we do not have a Chernobyl level disaster tonight. No one on Periscope. Everyone's busy eating. Alrighty. Okay, we can do this. We can do it. We can do it. They're gonna 1, 2, 3. Oh, one of them is gonna be much prettier than the other. It wasn't even a minute. Let's wait one more minute. I just want a little warmer. They're kind of like just a little over room temperature right now, which I wasn't really grooving on. One more minute. Waiting for the clock to tick. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. One more minute. Come on, come on, come on. So, we got the tin. We need the silverware. And napkins. Okay. The tasting table that you can sign up for the newsletter. Yes, you can do that too. Newsletters seem to be a thing. It's not my thing, but it's a thing. Every website in the world now is, I'm like, I'm on your site, I'm on your Facebook. Why do you keep wanting to give me a newsletter? I don't want any email. I don't want to ever get email ever again. Unless it's from someone I know to tell me something they can't tell me in a text. But that's me. But if there was a newsletter subscribed to, that would be one I would. I just see their stuff on Facebook constantly, so there's nothing in their newsletter that wouldn't be on, that I wouldn't see on their Facebook. So one of these is gonna be for pictures, and one of these is most definitely not. Can you tell which one is which? Okay, 2 and 3. Ah, hot. Okay. That's the better looking of the two. Then for the scary looking one. The one that will definitely not be photographed. That came apart 100%. We're gonna have lots of leftovers of the stuffing. Emily, yes. They had so many different list dad, like, 4 listings for a tasting table. That's why I wonder which one. Oh, I see. Yeah.
Yeah, I just find it on Facebook. But yes, they do have a newsletter. I now see what you meant. Okay, so here we go. Picture time. Ask husband, what is his favorite Disney character? Now I'm trying to see if I can guess. Boy, you know, we've known each other for so long. That would be like a newlywed game type question to see if I could get it on the first try. Okay, picture time. Boom. Alrighty, so here we go. He isn't here right now, so I would ask him. Han? Yeah. I'm serving. Sorry, I won't be able to ask him the question. I'll have to write you back his answer to see if it matched what I thought. Because we gotta eat, and it's like this. This is Ukraine, night two. We have our, oh boy. Mlyntsi, our meat-filled pancakes from Ukraine. This is the ugly one. Here's the prettier one. Alongside our beets and cream sauce. So that's it for night two of Ukraine. Oh, that's sweet, Emily. So that does it for tonight. Check out the blog tomorrow on at cliffyland.com. It will have pictures, links to the original recipes, links to these videos here, information about the countries, reviews of how everything went, and you can catch up on all the countries that you missed, all 181 of them. Yes, good. Thank you, Emily. Also, follow on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram. You said to remind you of a sauce or something. Oh, yes, thank you. Thank you. Boom, boom, boom. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. A million times thank you. Wow. Horseradish. Wowzers. Thank you so much. I'm gonna put it on the side. Because a little horseradish goes a long way. He likes horseradish more than I do. Yes. Yes. What is your favorite Disney character?
I guess Mickey and Steamboat Willie.
I should have known that. Steamboat Willie Mickey. Okay, so that's it again. One more time. Ding, ding, ding. Ding, ding, ding. And check out Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, Pinterest, YouTube. Follow on our YouTube. And check out next week when we head our second to last Arabian country, when we do the United Arab Emirates. So check that out. That'll be definitely Friday, or probably Friday, definitely Tuesday. So thanks again. Catch you next time. Till then, keep eating yum. Bye.